Hi, I'm Stefan. I'm one of the developers here at Code Institute, and today I'm going to talk to you about CSS. But before we do that, please subscribe, like, and share. CSS is what adds style and color to every web page. When we talk about style, we're talking about some of the basic yet extremely important things like fonts, font sizes, background, and text colors. A CSS file can be like a template that holds customized properties for how to style the HTML elements of a website. CSS files are used by designers to maintain a similar style throughout the entire web page. The file stores the properties for each page of the site within one place. This is incredibly useful when you're designing or redesigning a website because it means that you do not have to individually style each page. You can quickly and easily target one, some, or all specified elements on a single page, or even all pages of a site. A CSS selector is what we use to target HTML on our web pages that we intend on styling. A selector is part of a CSS rule. So what are then CSS rules? A CSS rule is made up of one or more selectors and a semicolon-separated list of declarations inside brackets. Each declaration has a property and a value separated by a colon. A rule is made up of one or more selectors. In the example, the selector is a paragraph element represented by the letter P. This means that the rule will apply to all paragraphs. This declaration states that the text color inside a paragraph will be teal. Note the spelling of color. Let's look at our previous example in our video about HTML. To add the styling now with our CSS, I'm going to add a style tag to the head, and that's where the CSS lives if you don't have it in an external file. So I'm going to add a P for a paragraph and then brackets. And within those brackets, we now have our key value pairs. So in this instance, we want to make the color teal. So I'm just going to add color here. And as mentioned, look at the spelling of color. It's just with an O, not OU. And then we want the color teal and always end with a semicolon. So we have the selector, brackets, our key value pairs, and separated by a colon and ending with a semicolon. And what this will do now is we'll color all the text within paragraph tags with the color teal. Now let's talk about external, internal, and inline CSS. As mentioned before, CSS can determine things like colors, fonts, borders, etc. that feature on the page. It can be used in three ways: inline, internal, and external. Here's the difference between the three. External style sheets are very useful, especially when you want to maintain one style throughout an entire site. The style rules need to be created just once, and they are applied to all required pages within the site. If you need to change the style slightly on all pages that are using the external sheet, then it just needs to be changed once and it automatically applies to all pages, which is really handy. In general, this is the standard way of using CSS. What is internal CSS compared to that? This applies to just the page that you're working on. This can be used if a unique style is required for one page of your web app. And then inline CSS. Inline CSS relates to a specific page element. We use CSS to turn a heading to the color red on the page. You'll notice that the order is embedded within HTML text, which is how it is written. Inline CSS is only used where you want to apply a unique style to one element. So now looking at our example from earlier, I'm going to apply some inline styles now on the H1 element. So as opposed to the internal and the external, this will only be applying to the H1 element. So the way that you do it is you just add a style attribute, and within the quotes for the style attribute, we're gonna define our key value pairs and terminate them with a semicolon. You can also chain them, so apply multiple inline styles on one element, which I'm gonna do now. So I'm gonna first apply color, colon, and then the color, which is going to be red, and then again terminate it with a semicolon. And then after that, I'm going to chain on now the font style, which I want to make italic. So italic, and again, terminate in a semicolon. And that's how you apply an inline style. If you want to learn some of the basics for free, then try our 5-day coding challenge. After just 1 hour a day for 5 days, you will have built your first ever web page. Register today and take your first steps in becoming a coder.